Hey everyone, welcome back to Vanguard. In this video today, we're going to talk about the final unlock for field upgrades called Dead Drop. This records your current killstreak score and awards it back to you in your next respawn. So this basically means your killstreak will persist through death, but it all depends on whether or not you activate that particular field upgrade. I'm also going to talk a little bit about the Riot Shield a little later in this video, so check those timestamps down below if you're interested in that. Initial thoughts on Dead Drop. I like the idea of it, especially for players who want to focus more on playing the objective. One thing that I've always appreciated about score streaks is you would get additional score for actually playing the objective. Getting kills while on that objective would boost your score, and this was done perfectly back in BO2 when it was originally introduced. Cold War brought us a hybrid system with a streak counter that actually didn't reset, so we had persisting streaks all the way throughout the year from the very beginning, and that was a polarizing subject in itself. But having killstreaks back, the classic killstreak system, with some pretty tough streaks out there, is great for many players. But it can be tough for new players who just jumped in during Cold War and expect to earn their streaks at least once or twice every single game. I feel like Dead Drop is the perfect middle ground for players who want to be aggressive on objectives or players who may just not be that good at the game. So you might be wondering, how does this work? Dead Drop is like any other field upgrade. You can earn it pretty quickly by getting kills, doing objectives, or just waiting it out, and the recharge rate is pretty fast. Activating it immediately will record all the kills that you get in your current life. Now let's say an attack dog comes around or a grenade hits you and you end up dying. When you respawn, your streak will still be there ready to continue. However, at this point, you gotta be careful, because if you get taken out in this new life, your streak will be lost and you'll have to restart all over again, unless you activate yet another Dead Drop. You can activate it every single life, and you can carry your streak all the way to the maximum kill streak you have selected. Now, although it doesn't say it distinctly in the description of the Dead Drop field upgrade, once you reach your maximum streak, you won't be able to earn any more in that particular match. And that makes sense. Considering you're carrying a streak through death, you shouldn't be able to earn them more than once in a single match. If, for some reason, you aren't able to make it to your final streak, but you have Dead Drop active and you've already earned your previous two streaks, those will not be earned again throughout the entirety of the match while using Dead Drop. And that's how it should be. If you're going to have your streaks persist through death, you should only be able to earn them once per game. The good news is, though, as long as you don't use Dead Drop, you can actually rotate through your streaks as many times as you'd like. The second you start earning streaks while Dead Drop is active, they will never be earned for the remainder of the match. That's pretty much the only downside to using Dead Drop, and I understand why they did it this way. It would be ridiculously overpowered if you were able to just continuously earn your streaks over and over and over again without having to worry about death. If that were the case, then I could definitely see them changing the recharge rate and how quickly you could earn this in game. I've also seen some conversation, people saying that maybe this should belong in a perk tier rather than a field upgrade, but it kind of makes sense here. You're jotting down a note, you're keeping track of your streaks, and then you're coming back with that in mind, which I think is strange, but kind of makes sense. Anyway, I want to move on to some Riot Shield gameplay, or Combat Shield is what it's called here in Vanguard. I haven't made this comparison yet on YouTube. I'm a little nervous too, but I'm going to throw it out there and I want to see what y'all say. I really feel like the movement speed in this game gives me heavy vibes of Modern Warfare 2 Melee days. When you just throw on lightweight and a combat knife and commando and you just run around the map absolutely acting like a demon. And that's how I feel about the movement in Vanguard. It's incredibly fast. I think this is one of the faster paced Call of Duty games that I've played in a very, very long time. And I'm definitely interested to know what y'all think about that in the comment section below. But the shield is no different here when it comes to movement. It's a little bit slower than your standard melee speed, but you're still moving extremely quickly. And this is going to help you quite a bit when it comes to completing some of these challenges. Now, very similar to previous games that feature some sort of ballistic shield, this will require 2 hits to kill in standard core modes, 1 hit to kill in hardcore. And that's going to be a very nice place for many people trying to complete challenges because you're required to get slide kills. And that can be pretty difficult when you need to hit twice. The melee speed is really, really slow. And I noticed that it tracks a little differently than other melee weapons we've seen in the past. It kind of does that lock-on thing where it connects you to a player, and once you're locked into that player, you have no other movement. You basically can't do anything until that animation is done. Now, this is either a good thing or a bad thing, but in core modes at least, it's a good thing, because when you start getting locked onto somebody, the entire shield basically locks onto their face, and they'll do anything they can to back up and try to shoot you, but there's a big shield in their face and they can't shoot through it, so they basically just have to accept their death because they cannot get away fast enough, especially if you apply lightweight as a perk and you're just running around like crazy on these maps. The shield is also infamously bad in this game when it comes to deflecting bullets. I don't know if it's just because of the way it looks from a first-person perspective, but I constantly feel like my head is peeking over the shield, and I always seem to die in a headshot. Maybe it's just coincidence, I don't know. I also feel like my feet aren't protected, like the shield itself is too small for my character. Probably designed that way. Like I said, I don't know. It's just a very strange situation. But this thing is bulletproof. It is capable of deflecting explosions, and it's a lot of fun to use, especially when you rock that overkill perk and you throw this on your back and you're running around with a knife doing whatever you can to get those challenges done as well. Like I had mentioned in my video from yesterday, I'm currently doing the Road to Gold, so I've been working on a bunch of different weapons to talk about them here and show you guys what the gold camo looks like in game. And unfortunately, the shield, the combat knife, and the double barrel I was working on all have challenge requirements that are currently broken and they can't be completed. So even though I have all of the challenges done, there's still one tier that I have to do for each one of those weapons, and for some reason they're just not unlocking. Whether it's because an attachment doesn't exist, like a magazine for a double barrel, or because the stun grenades just aren't registering. Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention the grenade launcher too. That's another one that I've currently finished up. Except the long shots are not tracking, so that's the last challenge I have to do. I'm really hoping by next week we can get like another patch. Maybe that's a little bit of wishful thinking, but hopefully these challenges will be fixed soon so we can start rolling along with the Road to Gold, and I'll have more episodes coming very soon for each and every one of you out there that have been enjoying the series so far. But that is pretty much everything I wanted to talk about here today. Dead drop, we got the riot shield, we got the combat knife, we got so much to do in this game. It is unbelievably fun, and I'm having such a great time with Vanguard. Let me know how y'all feel about it in the comments section below. I also just wanted to apologize for my voice. It's kind of hoarse right now because I feel it leaving my body. I'm losing my voice because of all the content I've made in the past couple of days. I think I've done like 16 or 17 videos so far, 9 of which have already went up over on my second channel, the entire Vanguard campaign playthrough in 4K. If you want to check that out, visit the link in the description below to the playlist. I appreciate y'all that have subscribed here on the channel and over there on the second channel. I'm really enjoying Vanguard a lot more than I thought I would, and it's just really been a fun vibe. So I appreciate y'all coming out and chilling with me on the channel. If you enjoy it, drop a like, subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day, and of course, don't forget to ring that bell icon to join the notification squad. I'll catch y'all on the next video. Peace.